In this video, I'm going to be breaking down a cover two defense, really a cover two, cover four style of defense that you can utilize that is very, very effective against a lot of the meta in Madden 21. What's up, guys? My name is Cody, and I want to thank you so much for taking the time out of your day to watch this video. Now, if you're new to the channel and you don't know what my channel is about, my channel is all about how to become a better Madden player in Madden 21. And the way that I help people become better at Madden is through posting tips and strategies like the one that I'm about to post, but also through answering your questions. And so if you have any questions, feel free to text those to me. My cell phone number is 812-216-3644. It is also in the top left-hand corner of your screen. Now, that being said, another way that I help people get better at this game is through posting videos on YouTube every single day. And so if you haven't subscribed yet, it's completely free to do that. All you have to do is hit that subscribe button at the bottom right-hand corner of the screen, and I'd encourage you to do that. That way you never miss one of these videos. All right, guys, so I'm going to be breaking down a defense that is in my Nickel 335 wide defensive ebook that I think can help some of you guys. And basically what we're going to be doing is we're going to go ahead and head into our coaching adjustments, and we're going to make a couple of adjustments to our zone drops. Now, the first adjustment that we're going to make is we're going to take our flats, and we are going to be putting those on either 25 or 30. I personally think 30 is a little bit safer, but you can also get away with putting them on 25. From that point, we're going to put our curl flats on 10, maybe even 15 or 5, depending on the situation, but 10 is a nice little middle ground. And then for hook curls, I actually like to put these on default for this defense, but you can also, if you are faced with someone who's running a lot of drag routes or underneath routes, you could put these at 5 yards as well. From there, we're going to put our option defense onto conservative, our ball and air defense to play ball, auto alignment is going to be set to default, and our auto flip is going to be on. Now, those of you that have already picked up the new the 335 wide defensive ebook know that one of the biggest tactics that I like to use is I like to come out in the 335 normal in the 46 playbook and audible down into the 335 wide. And the reason we like to do this is because it's going to get you very, very good personnel. But the defense we're going to be going over is the Cover 4 Show 2. It's a version of this. It's not exactly Cover 4. Technically, it's going to be cover two, but it's going to work very similar to a cover four style of defense. Now, on the offensive side of the ball, what we're going to do is we're just going to grab kind of the bunch tight end and show some of the different route combinations that people might use against this. And this is essentially a coverage defense. This could also be used as a pressure defense, depending on how you ran it. But essentially, all we're going to do is we're going to audible down into the cover four show two. Now, really quickly, I do want to point out, if you guys would like to get the full defensive ebook, I personally believe that the 335 wide and the 335 normal and nickel normal, that combination is the best four defense this year. It's the best three formation combination that you can have in your arsenal. You're going to be able to stop the run from this. You're going to be able to stop the pass from this. You're going to be able to play coverage defense, play pressure. You're also going to have some very nice unique man coverages and zone drops, as well as some match concepts as well from this defense, all rolled into one. And so if you want to get the best defense in Madden 21 and you want to learn how to run that against every single meta formation in this game, I would highly encourage you to pick up that 335 defensive guide, and that link is in the description of this video. So you can pick that up right now for just 15 bucks, and more on that in a little bit, but just wanted to let you know that right off the rip here. So all we're going to do is we're going to audible to the cover four show two, and we're going to basically press coverage. From that point, I like to make a couple of adjustments that I think is really going to help you to stop a lot of what people are going to do. The first adjustment is I am going to put both of my outside corners into those 25 to 30 yard cloud flats. And you're going to see that it's going to basically create a cover two type of look. From that point, I'm going to make two other adjustments I actually really like. I like to turn these quarter flat zones into seam flats. It's a relatively quick adjustment, as you can see right here. You know, if you know what you're doing, you can adjust it relatively quickly. From that point, I like to shift my, I always will shift that defensive line pretty much always to the side of the running back. So you're going to see there, I shifted it over to the side of the running back. And then I'm going to use my user right here. Now, from that point, I like to do really two basic things. I really like to have two yellow zones on the field at all times. I like to have a three reg hook, and I also like to have a vertical hook. Now, if you don't want to use a vertical hook, that's fine as well. You can simply man up the right of or the left side linebacker here. In this example, would be Adrian Amos. So, for example, I could take Adrian Amos and man him up on the triangle, or really anyone that I wanted to, whoever the problem receiver is. Typically, if someone goes into motion, I'll almost always man up the backside linebacker on that person. And then from that point, we're just dropping a bluff blitz here on the right side, and you're going to see that it's basically a Mabel coverage with a man-to-man assignment here. And I just want you to watch. I'm going to throw my user into kind of a mid-read zone just to show you kind of how this plays. But I just want you to kind of watch everything and see how this match coverage at the top of the defense really does a good job against a lot of what people like to offer. You're going to see here that if I try to throw this route to Davante Adams, that cloud flat is going to be able to be in a pretty good position to be able to stop crossing routes. It's going to be able to stop crossing routes. One of the other things that I really like about this is also going to be able to stop corner routes. So you'll see here, I mean, this doesn't take too long to set up. As you can see, I'm pretty much set up right here. And I'm just going to drop my, obviously you would be using your user, but I'm just going to drop him into coverage. And what you're going to see here, because again, the deep middle of the field, but if you take a look at this, what's really interesting is the route to Tavon Austin. You'll see that the match coverage will do a pretty good job of handling this stuff. As you see, if I try to throw that corner route, that cloud flat drops into that area and is able to make a play on the ball. One of the other things that I want you to do real quick is to take a look at instant replay, and I want to show you kind of how this coverage does against the streaks. And this is specifically designed to really help with like bunch compression, things like that. But if you take a look here, this is based out of a cover four quarter shell. And as you can see, that quarter zone does do a good job. I mean, obviously right here when they throw it over there, obviously he's going to go over there. But see how he's going to be running with this inside streak. Now, you might be in a situation where you'd say, well, that works, but what if they do X, Y, and Z, right? And I'm thinking, if I were you, I'm thinking about the play gun bunch verticals, which unfortunately I don't have that in here, but I do have a single back bunch that has kind of the same thing. And so what I want to do is I want to share that with you and just kind of show you how this is going to work against kind of a similar concept. Obviously, they would probably run this out of the regular gun bunch, but you can kind of accomplish the same. It's kind of a means to an end. So again, here, that simple cover two defense. And again, you want to make sure you're using the seam flats. I think that they play a little bit better. And again, we always want to man this guy right here, Adrian Amos, up. I like to man him up either on one of the two receivers, okay? It could be the left side guy. It could also be the middle guy, okay? It's up to you. And then we have the three rec there, and we have our middle read zone to Savage. Now, I want you to watch. Obviously, this is a concept that should be able to get open against this because you have three verticals and you only have two people defending the vertical threat. So I want you to watch kind of how this defense plays against this verticals concept. And as you'll see here, by the time that you have this ball off, because that cloud flat drops so deep into this play, you typically will actually get a very, very good ability to be able to stop some of these concepts. So for example, I'll give you another one. That would be the single back trio and going to the play, something like the play verticals. Now this is going to do a little bit better of a job. And again, this is not technically, this is not a compressed set. So you might want to consider a little bit of a different strategy. But all in all, you'll see that this defense actually will hold its own. Again, especially if I man this guy up onto anyone that I think is the problem. Obviously, if you're playing the Packers, you would probably man him up onto wherever Davante Adams goes. But if you watch these two vertical concepts here on the left side, obviously you have this one on the outside that they're able to hit, but the slot streak is covered. Okay, and so that's why, again, technically, if you're gonna, because if they motion out a streak, that's another little tactic that they might be able to do that it's going to be a little bit more beneficial to them. So let me give you an example of something like that. And again, this is just one little defense. In the ebook, we go over, you know, all kinds of different defenses for different situations. We give you all of the adjustments that you need to be able to be successful on the defensive side of the ball. So, you know, this is just one kind of version of this defense. So I just want you to know that right off the bat here. But if you take a look at what we're going to do on the offensive side of the ball, is let's say that we try to do something like what we're about to do here. We're going to basically take Adams, we're going to streak him, We're going to take Valdez Scantling. We're going to streak him. And then we might take Austin and put him on a, you know, whatever, a curl, a hitch, you know, whatever, really. Okay? And we motion this guy out and kind of snap it, like, right there. You're going to see here that this outside quarters or inside quarter zone will actually run with that streak. That's why this is such a good defense against the bunch. Now, I know that there's probably some other people that have talked about this. I know that Zan's talked about it a little bit. I know that Deuce Close has talked about this concept a little bit. But this is something that you can do specifically against compression. In my opinion, it doesn't quite work as good against, like, gun spread type looks. But against bunch, against really honestly even any 2x2. So, like, if I go to the doubles here, I want you to take a look at this. So if I go to the doubles here, you should see that now that we're in a spread set, if I streak both of these guys, now that's going to kind of cause issues. This is why I also think it's really, really important to put those seam flats on the field, because you'll find that those seam flats will sometimes actually climb all the way with those zones. So again, we'll just show you this. This is a spread concept. We got two streaks on the left. And then look at there. You see how they climb it? See that right there? See how 31 Amos is tracking with him? He's running a match. He's running a match principle, even though we've set a zone drop on him. It's one of the beauties of the 3-5 wide defense. Not every defense and not every shell is able to accomplish the same thing. But because you're using the cover four quarters scheme out of the 3-5 wide, take a look at this. This is actually relatively, in my opinion, very powerful defense. You see here, he's going to follow. And look at this right here. I mean, yes, there's a little bit of a window, but essentially 20 is kind of basically running stride for stride with both of these routes. Now, obviously, I'm going to go ahead and just show it to you one more time, and I want to force the ball in just to kind of show you, you know, that you can certainly hit that window, and so that's something that you need to be aware of. But all in all, I believe this defense really does a good job of kind of holding its own right up the seam. So again, we'll show it to you one more time. So again, and then like I said, you want to be matching, or not matching, I'm sorry, but you want to be manning up. Like if they're in a 2x2 set, you would definitely want to make sure that the man up goes, like if we just sent all four routes vertical, you'll see that the man coverage is going to go with them, the seam flats. But here, as you see here, if they do obviously throw this to the right, they can get this out. So that is something that you need to be aware of, which is why against spread sets, it doesn't make as much sense. But against compression set, it makes a lot of sense to use this defense. And when I say compression, I'm actually including the bunch tight end in something like this. So for example, maybe a motion that they might try to do out of the bunch tight end, you know, I'm not just, this is just something kind of that I'm thinking off the top of my head. And this is why whoever they motion over, in my opinion, it makes a lot of sense to man that player up. So let's say that I motion over Devontae Adams on a streak route, right? And let's say I put the tight end on the streak as well, and then maybe just do like a little drag underneath, right? Just something simple. But you'll see right here that Devontae Adams is going to get in man coverage. He's motioned out. And look at this right here. Everything is taken away. You see that that gives that man coverage. I mean, it's a really tight throw. That's probably even a click-on pick if they try to do something like that. Again, it comes back to my saying of like, if they're in compression, you don't have to have a deep blue zone there necessarily to be able to be effective. So anyways, that's a little bit of a little bit of a different defense for you to try out. I think it actually is very, very good against gun bunch, which is one of the reasons why one of the things that you'll see I'll do from time to time is let's say that they're running like traditional bunch, and just show, to illustrate this, I'm just going to motion out. Let's see if I can get this tight end to motion out here. I'm just going to motion out the tight end, right? So let's say that they're running something like this, like traditional gun bunch, right? You could go to that cover four show too, and essentially what you're going to do is you're going to play cover four on one side. So you're going to have that cover four defense on that right side, but on the left side, you're going to play that cover two style that I was telling you about. So you're going to basically readjust, go into your cover two setup here, and as you can see now, this is a very, very powerful defense because you're able to have, it basically gives you an extra defender to be able to defend, you know, anything that would be crossing, whether it be a motion slant, motion drag. You get a nice Mabel coverage over here. Like, to me, this is a relatively solid defense because the route combos that they can run is rather limited. I mean, there's not a ton they can do. And as you'll see, the quarter side will basically take that streak up the top. And now, you know, that window right there has become open, but there's some other things that you've now taken away. And what I would honestly do is probably just run traditional cover two on that right side as opposed to cover four, because you don't have to worry about the corner routes as much. It's more the crossing routes that you have to have to worry about against that defense. So, anyways, that's a little bit of coverages that I think you can use. I'm actually working on doing a little bit of a deep dive into the coverage system in Madden 21 and learning as much as I possibly can about that. So, again, if you want to get all of that finalized schematic tools and playbook, that is in our 335 wide ebook. It's just $15. It shows you how to do everything you need to know how to do from 335 wide against literally every formation. So it's a very, very good defense in my opinion, and it's helped a lot of people get top 100 in weekend league, compete in the Madden Classic, and you'll see the best of the best players in the game right now, the best of best players in community are running some version of the defense. And so, in my opinion, it is the best way to play defense in this year's game. So make sure to pick up that defense. That is in the description. And really quickly here at the end, just a little bit of a bonus. If you, maybe you're sitting on the fence and you're like, I don't really want to buy a book, or, you know, what does that get me? Well, what we've done is we've created a free 1 hour free sample for you. It's 1 hour of the ebook that is going to give you the core foundation, the core concepts that you can use. And then if you're still, if you like that one, that free sample, then obviously you can go ahead and pick up the rest of the ebook. So to get the free sample, literally all you have to do is just simply send me a text message. My cell phone number is in the top left hand corner of the screen. It is also in the description as well. So just hit me up via text message and just say, hey Cody, I'd like to get that 335 wide free sample ebook, and I'll shoot you a link to a private video that is specifically designed just for the people that have texted in, and you can get that. So anyways, all that to say, the defense is phenomenal, and I highly recommend picking up the entire scheme. It's helped a lot of people here at the channel, and honestly guys, it's helped me a ton as well as a player. This 335 wide defense is on a whole nother level in my opinion compared to pretty much any other defense in the community right now. So thanks for watching this video, and if you have any questions, feel free to hit me up via text message.